Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and thank you, Mr. Chairman. Now, in the past, unions have been about protecting workers. As a physician, I know that one of the major reasons for the increase in life expectancy between the first and second half of the last century was due in large part to increases in worker safety, which were brought about by actions of unions. I grew up in a union household. In fact, when my father was injured on the job, it was his union that helped represent him in court and helped put food on the table for my family. But too often, today's unions are more about politics and protecting their clout than protecting workers. This change in focus is exemplified by a Boeing union newsletter that stated, quote, 2,100 bargaining unit positions may be lost, end quote, if Boeing located a new manufacturing plant in South Carolina. Not jobs, not employees, not brothers and sisters, but bargaining unit positions. These employees were reduced to nothing more than a number. Employers must have the ability to locate where they can find the best employees, period. I worry that if the NLRB takes away the ability that prevents them from creating jobs in a right-to-work state like South Carolina, what does that mean for other right-to-work states like my state of Nevada, the state hardest hit by the recession and with the highest unemployment rates in the nation? Would the NLRB take similar action against a company trying to create jobs in Nevada? That's a risk Nevadans cannot afford to take. H.R. 2587 maintains an employer's ability to locate where they can find the best employees, and that is why I support this legislation, and I strongly urge my colleagues to do the same, and I yield back the balance of my time.